meditated on, and today we're really on the land and not in a building. So the land that we're located on, we're the current stewards of this land, is not always so. For thousands of years before Europeans and others arrived here, there were already peoples here who were stewards of this land. The Anishinaabe, the Attawandaron, Haudenosaunee, and others. And before there were people, the land was. As Christians and as indigenous peoples alike, we acknowledge that the land which sustains us all, the land on which we live and move and have our being, belongs to God, our Creator. So a couple of weeks ago, I talked about the petition to end the Korean War, and that effort is ongoing. So they're hoping for 10,000 signatures from the United Church of Canada, and I put the address, the virtual address, in the bulletin so that you can go on and sign that. You're interested in, just ask that where you get down to denomination, you put United Church of Canada so that they can track how many are coming in from us. Another announcement is I'm on vacation. After today's service, for a month, I'll be back on the 25th, Monday the 25th of July, and so the first service will be the 31st of July, and I believe that's a Dorchester Sunday. And some of you will know, others not. Last November, Barb's dad passed. And then on May the 30th, on her birthday, her mom passed. Tomorrow morning is the double service for her parents, and it's in Quebec tomorrow morning. So it's nothing personal. We love you all, but right after the service we're leaving. We're not staying for lunch. We've got to get down to Quebec today, so just to let you know that that's what's happening, we will be leaving right afterwards. So while I'm off for Dorchester, Mary Dillon is providing emergency pastoral coverage. For Union, Tom Beecroft is covering the first 2 weeks, and their phone numbers are in there. Matthew Penny, recently retired from Lambeth United, is covering the last 2 weeks, and he asked that we not publicly advertise his phone number. So if you reach out to either Roberta or Sally, they've got Matthew's phone number, and he'll be covering emergency pastoral care for the next 2 weeks. In terms of worship, Union is doing services the next 2 Sundays. So, and the hope is that it'll be here and online, in a perfect world. So everyone's invited to join that, either in person or online. And Mary Dillon has invited everyone to join them at either Reynolds Creek United Church in Putnam or St. John's in Springfield. And the service times are listed there in the bulletin as well. June outreach here at Union is the in, and there's a wish list. And I'm not going to repeat it all because it's printed today. And the Holy Diner is running Thursday evenings from 5 to 7 for July and August in the parking lot of Dorchester United. So that's a big thing. And there was a late addition. Lisa Gardner sent this in. Lisa and Sammy would like to thank our Dorchester United Church family for the love and support that we both felt last Sunday. To those who put together such kind words and beautiful singing during the service, the hard workers in the kitchen, the coverage of our usual posts, and everyone who came to be present for Sammy on that important day, it all meant so much, and we're truly grateful. So I know that there's one birthday coming up this week. Are there any others? Or anniversaries? Or birth announcements? So Fred Ford has a birthday coming up this week. 39 plus shipping and handling? Your birthday's not yet.
Ah, birthday candy, you don't blow them out of it.
Jesus Christ, the light of the earth. So we gather in song with some of you people.
Yes to salvation.
Yes to peace.
Yes to love.
Each one.
Everyone.
Of God's promises.
Is a yes.
And so we've come this morning to say our own yes.
We say yes to fellowship.
Yes to discipleship.
Yes to faith.
Yes to worship.
May our words.
May our lives be our yes. May our music.
May our lives be our yes back to God.
In this hour of worship, empower us for faithful living.
Come let us praise our Maker.
So our hymn is number 30, Some More Voices. It's a song of praise to the Maker.
To the Maker, some strings high in the tree. Thank you. hymn of love to God.
In the opening prayer. Lord, we came here to hear your word, but we were unprepared to hear you say, but Lord, we don't know where you're taking us. You repeated, yes, Lord, we said, but first we have to
impress.
Just as soon as we emerge. Lord, forgive us when we put our fears, our concerns, our agendas ahead of your call. Reassure us that you will go with us and we need not fear. Release us from our bondage to the things we think we cannot live without. Instill in our hearts and minds the gospel of the kingdom of God, that we may freely respond to your call. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you.
birthday. And children of many ages, yeah, Becky. Becky, we've got children. Becky's our one of our Sunday school leaders, and Valerie over here is the other one.
Okay.
So, has anybody ever felt afraid? Yep. What were you afraid of?
Falling?
Lost? Getting lost?
Future.
The future?
How do we live with that?
Staying on the road in a snowstorm, yeah.
Running a little, the dark.
The dark? Future of your family. Climate change.
I don't want people to know. Bees and spiders.
Bees and spiders. Snakes.
Yes.
What did you do when you felt afraid?
Run.
Yep.
Run and scream if it's a snake. Okay.
Yeah.
Anybody else?
Faint.
Pray. That's a good answer, Diane.
I had peanut butter and toast.
Nightlight, if it's the dark. Turn the light on. What do you do if there's a spider?
I don't know. What did you do this morning when there was a spider? There was some rats screaming. And then what? Did mommy get it out of the floor?
Call mommy.
Yeah.
The author of Psalm 77 writes of a time when started remembering all of the things that God had done and the promises that God had made. When he thought of all of the good things that God had done, and when he remembered all of the promises God made, he felt better. He felt reassured. He felt unafraid. Because he knew God was always here with us. Especially when we're afraid. And he knew that God would never leave him. So the next time you feel afraid of something, you think you might try remembering God's actions and God's promises. Or maybe, like Diane said, say a prayer. Because prayer is at least 50% listening, right, Diane? Listening for God's answer. Think that that'll help you feel unafraid next time. Not if it's a snake, eh? God made the snake. Some of them are poison. So we pray. Dear God, thank you for all you have done, for the promises you make to us to be with us in good times and in fearful times. Amen. So we're going to sing verses 1 to 5 and 7 of 163 for more voices. River running in you and me.
So
scared to swim with fairy doll down. Give us the courage to journey on. River on me, river on me.
On the road of life, we encounter others who may need our help or who may help us. Whatever we have, God invites us to share generously and unconditionally. Tithes and offerings that we receive. Canada Post, by FAR, by Canada Health, right? The offering plate over there with a brick on it so it doesn't blow away. Bless all that we offer with thanksgiving in our hearts. Use what we offer to make your kingdom a reality in our world and in our time. In Jesus' name we pray. People said, Amen. Are there any prayer requests?
And no spinning tickets.
For Ukraine, and the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Israel-Palestine, and Afghanistan, and all the other places where there's war and terror.
For American women.
And for American women. Others? Going once?
Thank God we live in Canada, not the States.
Thankful that we live here and not in the States.
Yeah. Yep. I'll say.
See, here we have the right to bear arms, too. Going twice? Going three times? Let's pray. Holy One, it's summertime. The first Sunday of summer, even. Time for the refreshment and renewal of our spirits that is so necessary before we can refocus our efforts. Grant us a time of fun and frivolity, of rest and relaxation. Grant us dreams and visions of all that we could be as individuals and as a faith community. Restore our souls, our minds, our bodies. We pray that we would not become so invested in your church that we mistake it for our own. We pray for your church throughout the world and for St. Paul's United Church in Sarnia as they hold their final service today. So does Ravenswood. We pray that we would not become so focused on the needs in our own community, in our own nation, that we would forget. forget about others with whom we share your creation. We think of all peoples everywhere. Especially this week, we think of the people of Kenya, Tanzania. We pray for all who mourn a loss in their lives. We ask that you would grant them peace and comfort. We think especially of the friends and family of Eileen Gill. We pray for all who are ill or dying, awaiting medical intervention or recovering from treatment. We ask that you would renew their strength and their health. Pray especially for Paul McMillan and Mary Kaiser, and their loved ones and caregivers, and those known only in the silence of our own hearts. This we pray in the name of the one who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Yours is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our responsive reading this morning is Psalm 77. I cry aloud to God. I cry that God may hear me.
In my time of distress, I pray to God.
Then I recall your deeds, O God. I remember your wonders of old. I recount all your works and ponder the things you have done. You are the one who works wonders. You have shown your strength among nations. The waters saw you, O God. The waters saw you and churned in fear. Clouds streamed water, the heavens rumbled. The voice of your thunder was heard in the whirlwind. Your way was through the sea. Your footprint could not be seen. And the scripture lesson for this morning is 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 14 verses. Listen for the word of God. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, Stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel. But Elisha said, As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you. So they went down to Bethel. The company of prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, Do you know that today the Lord will take your master from you? And he said, Yes, I know. Keep silent. Elijah said to him, Elisha, stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho. But he said, as the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you. So they came to Jericho. The company of prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you? And he answered, yes, I know. Keep silent. Then Elijah said to him, stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan. But he said, as the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you. So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went and stood at some distance from them, as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to one side and to the other, crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you. Elisha said, please let me inherit a double share of your spirit. You have asked a hard thing, yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted. If not, it will not. As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them. And Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen. But when he could no longer see him, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. He picked up the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him, went back and stood on the bank of the Jordan. He took the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him and struck the water. He said, where is the Lord, the God of Elijah? Where is he? He struck the water again, and the water was parted to the one side and to the other, and Elisha crossed over. Number 82 from Voices United. The light is gleaming.
Now we love you.
spreading its arms around the world.
So in the Old Testament lesson, follow on to the lesson that we read a week ago about Elijah and Elisha. In the Old Testament lesson, Elijah is about to be taken up into the heavens. Not once, not twice, but three times he tells Elisha to stay behind. And not once, not twice, but three times, Elisha refuses to leave his side. It becomes obvious during the reading that Elisha knows what's about to happen. In fact, he tells the company of prophets, both in Bethel and in Jericho, as much. I wonder, is Elisha suffering from FOMO, fear of missing out? And what is it that he doesn't want to miss out on? Finally, on the other side of the Jordan, Elijah asks Elisha what it is that he wants. It seems that our society, especially in the last couple of years, has become extremely divided, suspicious, intolerant, filled with hatred and vitriol and rage. We have conservatives versus liberals, or if you're south of the border, Republicans versus Democrats, pro-mask versus anti-mask, pro-vax versus anti-vax, people who want rules to protect us all versus freedom fighters who reject any and all forms of restriction, pro-gun versus gun control, racialized hatred directed against indigenous people, people of color, and people of non-white Christian cultural and religious backgrounds like the Afzal family. Hatred directed at the LGBTQ2S+ community with flags stolen and the mass shooting in Norway. And now, this weekend, it's pro-life versus pro-choice. The question I have is, why? Why all the suspicion? Why all the intolerance? Why all of the hatred and vitriol and rage and acts of violence? Why? You, but it doesn't make any sense to me. And I wonder, could it be fear? Could it be fear of change? Could it be FOMO, fear of missing out on what some feel entitled to? Fear of missing out on positions of privilege? Fear of missing out on social power? Fear of missing out on control. ponder. The psalmist in the lesson was distressed, perhaps even fearful of what was happening in his life and in his community. However, instead of heading down to the local gun shop to buy an AK-47 and several cases of ammunition so he could kill whomever he blamed for his distress, he sat with God, and he remembered all of the blessings of his life and in the life of his people. He remembered all of the good things that God had done in the past. Remember, Dr. Phil says the best indicator of future behavior is past behavior. God can be trusted to keep God's promises because God has been shown to be faithful in the past. There is more need for Christians to speak up about the state of our society now than ever before. As Christians, we need to speak up about the lack of respect people have for one another. We need to speak up about intolerance, whether it's intolerance directed against indigenous peoples, people of color, the LGBTQ2S+ community, immigrants, refugees, pro-vax, pro-choice, NDP, or any other identifiable group. Why? Because Jesus calls us to be inclusive. Why? Because God is pro-life. God created all of us, not just the ones with blue eyes or brown hair or any hair at all. You get the idea, right? God created all of us. But you may say, it's uncomfortable to confront someone who's shouting obscenities at another person because of, well, for any reason. It could be dangerous if that person turns their attack on us. It could be life-threatening if they have a weapon. I say, so? Jesus calls us to take up our cross and to spread the good news of the kingdom of God in word and in deed. Jesus calls us to be bold in our discipleship, and to be daring in situations of injustice. Jesus calls us to have FOMO, fear of missing out on a world where all people, where all of creation is respected, and where everyone has what they need, not only to survive, but to thrive. That's what we should fear missing out on. That is justice and righteousness. So I say to you, go and make it so. Amen. We're closing hymn is number 135 for More Voices. All by earth and sky. Thank you. Somebody gets Diane a dish so she can eat because her daughter's coming back to get her at, is it 11:30?
Oh,
yeah, 11:30, whether she's done or not, so get that woman a plate first. So, does everyone know Johnny Appleseed?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
The
so I thank the Lord for giving me the things I need. Some of the many apple seeds, Lord, is good to me.
Amen. May God bless us this summer.
Give us a time of travel, adventure, exploration, and rest.
May we be open to seeing God in everything around us,
in everything we need, and in ourselves.
May we love God in these many iterations of God's abundant creation.
Every step of everywhere we go.